right into it. What inspired you to act? We both actually come from a musical theater background. Represent.
Oh my God, that's amazing. Well, I started acting when I was 8. And my mother actually heard an audition Lion King on Broadway on the radio one day. And we decided to take a gander at auditioning for it. And that was my first big role. And after that, I knew that this was something that I really wanted to do for the rest of my life. So I kept auditioning and kept working, and here we are today.
That's great. What was your callback and audition process like for them?
Surprisingly, it was a pretty simple process with the audition. Little Marvin had told me that he already had me in mind for the role.
Oh, wow.
He still wanted me to audition, so I did a self-tape here from my house, actually, and I got one more call back after that, and then I got the call that I had booked the role. So that was very, very exciting, just because I was so attracted to the project as soon as I had read the character description, so it was just such an amazing opportunity.
How important is it to create more diverse roles in films out there for people of color, especially girls? You are representing a new era of strong women.
Yeah, I mean, I am all for representation. I feel like it's very, very important, especially in the entertainment industry. It's so vital just to growing minds, especially for Black boys and girls. So I'm very grateful that I get to do what I do so that I can showcase myself as representation for, you know, young dark-skinned girls, you know, especially who want to get into the industry. And I remember when I was younger, I never really used to see anybody who, you know, really looked like me. But we now are in a different time now, and things are improving. So I'm really glad that I get to do what I do.
If you could describe Ruby in one word, what would it be?
I guess one word would be witty. I feel like she is very aware and very intuitive. And I really love that about her. She's such a clever girl. And, you know, I know that she's still, you know, a growing person going into high school, still trying to figure herself out, you know, and that can be really tough. And I think that that's one of the ways that I relate to her as well.
Right, right. What made you go from musical theater to horror? Is this a genre you see yourself in for a while, or are you open to new projects?
Yeah, I'm most definitely open to more genres. I think that I would want to do a different genre after this one, just because I don't want to, you know, pigeonhole myself into, you know, this genre, because I can do more, and I do have range when it comes to just my acting skill set. But I really do love, you know, drama and, you know, indie coming of age stories. I really do like that, and that's probably something that I would want to do next.
What was it like working on them? Where did you shoot?
Well, we shot in California. We shot in Pacoima and Pomona. And those places were a lot of fun to shoot, because we would shoot sometimes at this farm. And that was really fun, because Melody and I got to, like, run around quote-unquote gym class. And we would always, like, do school together there as well, so it was just a great time.
Oh, that sounds awesome. What drew you to Ruby? Is it easy to tell her story?
I gotta say, it is not easy to tell her story at all, you know?
Okay.
She is such a specific character, and she really is going through a lot. She's dealing with her self-acceptance with her skin color, and just her being accepted in her school, as the only Black girl in her entire school. She's also dealing with problems at home with her parents, and, you know, the generational trauma that she's experienced. And she's also still trying to keep her, you know, keep her little sister as innocent as possible for as long as she can, because she knows how the real world is. So she does go through a lot. So it was very difficult to portray the role, but I really did try my best to get an accurate representation of the teenage Black girl experience.
What do you hope this series accomplishes for the critics? Is there a specific message you want to get out there?
I think that I really just want them to know that this story is a form of education as well, you know, not just entertainment. And I feel like this is the absolute perfect, you know, project for horror, because it has to do with real traumatic experiences, and, you know, racism is absolutely terrifying. So I think that this is a great genre to put it in, and I feel like Little Marvin and Lena Waithe have created such a beautiful, you know, a beautiful project with this. So mm-hmm. I really am grateful.
You guys did a great job.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. I loved how it weaved historical events with a fictional world. Can you tell me about the ghost we encounter, especially Ruby's friend that no one sees? Is there any more backstory than what we see?
Not much that I have gotten about Miss Doris, but I do know that, you know, Doris is a figment of, you know, a figment and a creation of Ruby's own problems at home and all of the things that she is handling, you know, mm-hmm. As a teenage girl. And Doris knows exactly what she's going through in her head, and she uses those issues against her, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And you can kind of see all of that unfolding through the project, and I really do have to applaud Miss Sophie Guest, who plays Doris, because mm-hmm. she was such a great partner during all of that. And she's such a professional. I really Aww. Do love her.
So would you say it's more like delusions that they're having, or do you think it's actual dead people?
I would say that it is most definitely more of delusion, just from my take of the entire thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that it most definitely is created from the house in particular, and just being in the neighborhood with mm-hmm. all of these white people who do not want you there. You
right,
know?
Right.
And I feel like throughout the entire series, everybody is saying that, you know, living in a white neighborhood could literally, like, make you crazy. And mm-hmm. I feel like that's exactly what we're seeing. We're seeing the depth and the psychological part of all of this, you know, of what happens with these tiny little microaggressions that can just build up and kind of explode inside.
What is your advice yeah. to other aspiring actresses?
Ooh, I would really say keep going, for mm-hmm. real, just because in this industry specifically, you're going to have a lot more no's
yes.
When it comes to the project that you want, but you can literally, you'll never know until you really, really try and you really go at it. So I say to really do have, keep your determination up, because it's a very long process, but what's mm-hmm. for you?
What's next for you after them? Is there any more projects in the iron that you're working on, or?
Nothing that I can talk about right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I will most definitely keep you updated with that.
Yeah, for sure. That would be great. Would you like to direct someday or write? You seem really creative. Like, you knit, and you have a dance background, a music background. There's a lot of, you know, different pieces you could put into things.
I already have a production company, so I would love to produce something. And I absolutely love writing. So I would totally want to write something one day.
What's the name of your production company?
It's called Shoujo Enterprises.
Okay.
And originally it was created to help with our taxes, really.
Right.
But we would actually want to, you know, use it for, you know, current projects that would be coming up next in the future.
Is there anything funny that happened on set, like for bloopers? Because it's such a serious, like, historical film.
Yes.
But there had to be something that, you know, could break character and make you guys smile.
Totally. You know, I, throughout the entire process, I really enjoyed having Melody on set, just because she's the youngest on set, and she really is very, very, you know, innocent when it comes to all of this.
Mm-hmm.
So I really enjoyed having that positive energy on set at all times. And in some of our scenes, we literally could not stay serious, and she would make me laugh. I hope that they share those one day, because those fun times on set were just, you know, irreplaceable.